thin lenses, another thin lens problem. All I'm told is I have an object in front of a symmetric mirror. So I don't know if it's concave or convex, but it's symmetric, so the radius of curvature of both will be the same. It magnifies at negative 0.25. Now this immediately tells me this is an inverted image, it is reduced in size, and I'm told the refractive index just of that lens. What can I say about the type of lens? What can I say about where this object is placed? Is it closer to the lens than the focal point? Is it away from? What can I say? Well, I know that n equals negative si divided by s zero. That means si equals negative n s zero. So there'll be negative a quarter times 20. That equals 5 in my book, 5.00 centimeters. So I have an inverted image. It is a real in as much as SI is positive, so it's on the opposite side of the lens, and it is inverted with that negative, and the only thing that will give me that is going to be a biconvex lens, in other words a converging lens, both sides convex because it's symmetric, remember, and we can clearly see, I think, that this is going to be beyond the only way that converging lens is going to give us an inverted real image as if S0 is placed further away than the focal point indeed. Let's see if we can calculate what that focal point is going to be. Well, 1 over S0 plus 1 over SI is going to equal 1 over F. So I have 1 over 20 plus 1 over 5 is going to give me 1 over F. And so that's over 20 will make this times 4 is 20, so 4 is 5 over 20, which is 1 over 4. 1 over 4 equals 1 over f, so I get a focal distance. Let me just see that it's 4.00 centimeters. And indeed, it is placed well beyond that focal point. Now, what is the radius of curvature? Now, just be very careful. Again, remember, we just said it's symmetrical. We said it's converging, and the medium, the refractive index of the medium is higher than the medium that it is in. So remember, we saw another example where if the refractive index of this medium outside was 2 or 1.7, and then this will become a diverging lens. But in this instance, it's a converging lens. So my object is on this side. So first of all, this closest surface will be R1, this will be R2. This is a convex surface, this means it will have a positive sign. This object here on this side faces a concave surface, in other words, this will be a negative. So I'm going to have 1 over f, which are now minus 4, is going to be in 1 over n2, I always do that, minus 1, and I'm going to have 1 over r1 minus 1 over r2. So 1 over f is going to be 1 over 4 equals n1 is always. The numerator is N1, that is the refractive index of the lens itself, which for us is 1.65, over the refractive index of the medium in which this lens is, which is this air, which is 1.00 minus 1. And now we're going to have 1 over R, because they both have exactly the same R1 equals R2, it's only the sign. But this R2 is negative. Negative times a negative is a positive, so it's going to be another 1 over r. So that's 2 over r. R is the only unknown, the only variable in my equation there, so I can solve for r. Do it yourself. I get an answer r of, I think, 5.2 centimeters. So converging lens, I've placed this object well beyond the focal point. It gives me an inverted real image. It is reduced in size, it's inverted, it is real. So much information just because of my sign convention. Now let's do a new type of problem, and we're going to have two lenses, but they don't touch. We're going to have two convex lenses. They are on the same axis, and this one has a focal distance of, I think the first one was 24 centimeters, and this other one had a focal distance of 9.00 centimeters. And I'm placing an object here at, I think was at 6 centimeters. So this distance is 6 centimeters. and these two are 10 centimeters apart, 10.0 centimeters apart. I want to know what the final image is. Will it be real or virtual? Will it be upright or inverted? And the way that we do these problems is we first ignore the second lens, and we get the image, and then we ignore the first lens. So let's do that. So we're going to have 1 over S0, it is 6 centimeters from this first lens. So 1 over 6 plus 1 over SI, we need to know SI, it's going to be 1 over the focal distance just of this length, lens, which is 24. And that gives us an SI, do that yourself, I think it is, well, mine was negative 8 centimeters. Negative 8.00 centimeters. Now we could already have, you know, have imagined that in as much as the focal distance of this lens is 24 centimeters. 24 centimeters, so it is well within 24 centimeters, it's at 6. So it was going to give us a virtual image which was going to be on this side. I could work out the magnification. That I do magnification as about 1 1/3 times, and it's positive, so it's going to stand upright, and it's going to stand here 8 centimeters. Because that is negative, it's on the same side as this object. Now, I'm going to ignore this lens, and I'm going to use this new image of mine, which I got from this. And now I'm going to have 1 over S0. Now, this S0 is this 8 centimeters from there, plus they are 10 centimeters, so this thing is 18 centimeters away from the second lens. 1 over SI, and that's going to go 1 over the focal length. Now imagine this one has a focal length of 9 centimeters, I'm placing it 18 centimeters away. What are we going to get? We're going to get a real inverted image, nothing other than that. And 1 over F for this one is the line. And if I do that, check for yourself, I think I got 18 centimeters. 18 centimeters, in other words, it's going to be on this side because this is positive. I'm ignoring this lens completely for the second round, and it is obviously going to be 18, and if magnification equals negative SI over S0, I'm going to get negative 18 over, it is focal S0. Remember, my S0 was now this 18 centimeters here, over 18, and that's going to be a negative 1, so it's going to be it's going to be the exact same size, but it's obviously going to be inverted. But that's not what the problem asks. The problem asks, where is my final image going to be? It is going to be on this side, 18 centimeters away from this second lens.